Something precious might be hiding below the moon's surface. Chandrayaan-3 ISRO mission. Save the date, August 23rd, 2024. That will be the first National Space Day ever celebrated in India. Yes, the first one, because this day was set aside in India to commemorate one of the most relevant scientific achievements of the century, the successful landing on the moon by the Chandrayaan-3 mission. Needless to say, landing on the moon is no picnic, but landing on the South Pole is even harder due to the mountainous terrain, craters, and unpredictable lighting. Yet the mission was a success. Armed with a lander and a rover, the Indian Space Research Organization, ISRO, ventured on a quest to find out more about our moon. What is it made of? How did it really form? Most importantly, they wanted to find in situ proof of the existence of water on the surface. Scientists found all kinds of molecules and even detected what is thought to be a moonquake. However, they could not find any signs of water. This raises the $1 billion question. Where is water on the moon? Chandrayaan-3 and Chandrayaan-2. The good missions are the ones where you go where nobody has gone before, and you do the things nobody has done before. According to this statement, Chandrayaan-3 was definitely one of the best missions of the decade. Scheduled to last 5 months and 22 days, it was launched on July 14, 2023 from the Satish Dhawan Space Center in Sriharikota, India. The propulsion module, which carried the lander and rover configuration to a 62-mile, 100-kilometer lunar orbit, was so well designed and taken care of that a few months later, on December 4, 2023, it was reinserted into an orbit around the Earth, with the primary objective to even allow for Earth observation. The lander named Vikram successfully soft-landed on the moon and opened its belly to let the Pragyan rover wander around on the regolith surface for a total of 1 lunar day, corresponding to around 14 Earth days. Everything went quite smoothly, especially if you compare it to the Chandrayaan-2 failed mission. This one landed on July 22, 2019, never made it to the lunar surface. I mean, technically it did, only it crashed on it due to a deviation from its intended trajectory while attempting the soft landing in September of 2019. The crash was likely caused by a software glitch. The rest of the former twins, Vikram and Pragyan's lander and rover, which were built for the Chandrayaan-2, now lie dead on the moon. As for Chandrayaan-3, no software glitches occurred, and engineers also took some time to upgrade Vikram and Pragyan with respect to their twin configuration. Unlike Chandrayaan-2's lander, which had 5 engines with a centrally mounted 5th engine capable only of fixed thrust, Chandrayaan-3's lander is equipped with 4 variable thrust engines with slew rate changing capabilities. Moreover, the altitude correction rate has been increased from 10 degrees per second in Chandrayaan-2 to 25 degrees per second in Chandrayaan-3. Its impact legs are stronger compared to Chandrayaan-2. Additionally, the targeting of a more precise landing location of 16 kilometers squared or 6.2 square miles is based on images provided by the Orbiter High Resolution Camera, OHRC, on board Chandrayaan-2's orbiter. Structural rigidity has been improved. Poling and instruments increased in multiple contingency systems added to enhance lander survivability in case of failure during descent and landing. These are just some of the strengths behind the amazing Indian mission. Hey, before moving on, be sure to like or dislike the video so that we can improve it for you, the viewer. Plus, don't forget to subscribe to our channel by making sure to hit the notification bell so you don't miss any of our daily videos. Water evidence. As you might have thought, there must have been a Chandrayaan-1 mission too, right? And if so, was it a copy of the latter? Or was it something different? What was its purpose? Chandrayaan-1 was India's very first lunar probe. It was launched almost 16 years ago on October 22, 2008, with the goal of exploring the moon and conducting various scientific experiments. The mission marked a significant milestone for India's space program, making it the first Asian country to reach lunar orbit and the first in the world to do so in over 30 years. Key objectives and instruments aboard Chandrayaan-1 included mapping the moon's surface, studying its mineral composition, and searching for water molecules. The spacecraft carried 11 scientific instruments, including a Moon Impact Probe, MIP, that was released and impacted the lunar surface. Chandrayaan-1 made several significant discoveries, including the confirmation of water molecules on the moon's surface. However, the mission faced challenges when communication with the spacecraft was lost in August of 2009. Despite this, Chandrayaan-1's contribution significantly expanded our understanding of the moon and paved the way for subsequent lunar missions, including Chandrayaan-2 and Chandrayaan-3. The moon, previously thought to be a dry and hostile place, was now found to be wet. The amount of water hidden in the lunar poles of the moon was later estimated to be around 600 billion kilograms. That's enough to fill at least 240,000 Olympic-sized swimming pools. The water molecules were believed to be distributed across the lunar surface and possibly trapped in minerals or in the form of ice in permanently shadowed regions. This discovery had important implications for future lunar exploration and potential resource utilization, as water is crucial for supporting future human missions by providing essential resources for life support and fuel. It is clear that subsequent missions, including Chandrayaan-2, would have had the major scope of unveiling where exactly this ice was. The main idea was to look inside the moon's craters. There are some reasons behind this choice. Permanently shadowed regions on the moon, located near the lunar poles, have temperatures that are extremely low and lack direct sunlight. These areas are believed to trap and accumulate water ice. Moreover, some in-orbit observations have also detected hydrogen, a component of water coming straight from these shadowed regions. Last but not least, theoretical models and simulations based on the moon's thermal environment and surface conditions also support the idea that water ice could exist in these permanently shadowed regions. That was the deal with the failed Chandrayaan-2 mission. Luckily, India did not give up and sent Chandrayaan-3. The upgraded Vikram and Pragyan made some incredible discoveries. Traces of sulfur, oxygen, even calcium and chromium were found in the chemical studies to address the actual composition of the moon soil at the South Pole. This was made possible by the laser-induced breakdown spectroscopy instrument. To observe a substance, LIBS fires laser pulses at a sample, which then vaporizes it into a brief plasma, which then re-emits some light depending on its composition. Aluminum, titanium, silicon, iron, and manganese are among the other key elements found. These were already known to be on the moon since the first Apollo missions, but having a more complete chemical composition of the lunar South Pole area means future travelers or colonies of the region will also be able to plan for what else they don't need to bring from Earth. For instance, sulfur could be used by moon dwellers in bits of infrastructure such as building materials, solar cells, and batteries. Yet one thing left scientists a bit disappointed. Among all the elements, there was a missing one: hydrogen, the major component of water, together with oxygen. It really seems like upcoming missions will have to dig deeper into this mystery if they want to find water ice. And I mean it quite literally. Yes, because, among other things, the mission also took the very first ever temperature measurements of the lunar South Pole region soil. The CHAST instrument, present on the lander module and designed to study the heat conductivity of the lunar surface and measure the differences in temperatures at different points on and below it, found out that the temperature decreases as you go down. The maximum temperature of about 140 degrees Fahrenheit or 60 degrees Celsius was found 20 millimeters above the zero level. Under that, a steep decrease in the temperatures was observed, reaching minus 14 degrees Fahrenheit, minus 10 Celsius, at a depth of 80 millimeters. This has two important consequences. First, it shows that the lunar regolith is not as good at conducting the heat as we previously thought. And second, whoever wants to find some water ice on the moon, well, they probably have to dig a bit. Perhaps the 600 billion kilograms of water ice observed by the Chandrayaan-1 orbiter is hidden under the lunar regolith at a way higher depth than previously thought. As you can understand, although no actual trace of water was found by Chandrayaan-3, the mission gave us valuable insights for future missions that will try to address that mystery. The slow-moving rover. ISRO has released an image showcasing the progress of Pragyan's rover exploration on the moon as it reaches a distance of 100 meters. While it may seem slow compared to Usain Bolt's speed, it's important to remember unique challenges of lunar terrain. Due to the conditions, rovers must move in a crawl, with Chandrayaan moving at a speed of 1 centimeter per second. The image reveals that the rover had to alter its path after encountering a crater along the way. Additionally, ISRO shared a video captured by Vikram's lander imager camera, demonstrating Chandrayaan's rotation as it sought out a safer route. The ISRO tweeted, or should we say axed, "It feels as though a child is playfully frolicking in the yards of Chandra Mama, while the mother watches affectionately, isn't it?" The end of mission. The Chandrayaan rover and Vikram lander conducted research on the moon's surface throughout a single lunar day, lasting around 14 Earth days. This lunar day began on August 23rd, and both the rover and lander relied on solar power. After 14 Earth days, the lunar day ended, and the moon entered a period of darkness lasting 14 to 15 Earth days, during which the temperature dropped to minus 292 degrees Fahrenheit or 180 degrees Celsius. Scientists were aware that the Vikram lander and Chandrayaan rover would be incapable of functioning in such extreme lunar nighttime conditions. However, they believed that the mission could surpass this time frame and become operational again once exposed to sunlight. If the systems were able to endure until the next lunar day, the rover could potentially continue its exploration. Unfortunately, this expectation was not met, and the lander and rover never reached their second lunar day. It is unfortunate to consider the missed opportunity for further invaluable scientific discoveries that could have been made in those additional 14 days. Nonetheless, Chandrayaan-3 has undoubtedly been one heck of a mission. The results it provided humanity with are ready to be inserted in the new scientific books. Now the moon will never be the same. That's all for this video. Thanks for watching. Do you think we will ever be able to find water on the moon and maybe use it as a resource? Let us know in the comments below. We'll see you next time on the channel.